containers. You've got to take a scrap. We're going to start every piece. Okay, just going to start every piece, make sure we're solid on everything. Okay, percussion, don't worry about going to Team Symphony really. We just want to start. Okay, it's definitely an F concert followed by B flat concert. F concert is cool. have more stuff to put in when you set up right there. Okay, we good back there, Jess? Okay, we will be good. I won't start without you, I promise. And do what you need to do. We'll go into the transition. Don't worry about changing timpani pitches right now. Just be sure your music's there. Too bad. Big band selfie, you ready? You got one on the side? Get in the side. Ready? Okay. Ready? Okay, here we go. Here's the middle. And in the middle. And okay, and in the side. Whoa. Dangerous. We're dangerous. Okay. In the side. Oh, wait, wait. Oh, there we go. Okay. Thank you for indulging. I appreciate it. 3 minutes to talk.
So I'm gonna go check
taxes.
Thank you.
Thank you. I just want to say a couple of things, just because they're amazing, which means you raised them. So congratulations to you all. Thank you, Dr. Ulrich, for having me. And this is a lot of trust, just saying. I just met them Thursday night. And we literally, for each song, it was maybe an hour and 15 minutes max of rehearsal that we have had over the past couple of days. And it's just, unless you're a musician, you really don't comprehend how amazing that actually is. I told them that their band directors are always right. You guys are doing great things. And the best decision you made for them is to encourage them to be in something like this. I was not one of those kids in band that had parents who played instruments. I came home and I said, hey, Mom, I'm going to join band. And she's like, why? Like, why are you going to do that? I was like, I don't know, because my friends are. And that's literally what happened. So I did, and look what the opportunities that it brought me. And it wasn't until I started going to honor bands that I really understood who my people were. So this has given me opportunities that I did not see coming, and I'm sure that is true for them. So whatever they end up doing, it's going to be great in their life, and this is going to be part of that journey. I want to say special thank you to William, who has been immensely helpful in the percussion section back here, and to Hannah, who's been my right-hand person, worked very hard to put all of this together, and I do thank each and every one of you and these students who have done everything I asked them to do. You should be so proud. So thank you, and thank you all.
Thank you.
quick. Okay. Boom. Okay. You guys are awesome. Hey, we have more treats for you backstage. Yeah. You go. Thank you guys. You were awesome. Anybody gonna be at the Memphis camp this summer? University.
How do we get home your sister? Ma'am? My daughter is Stacy Williams. Will I be able to find her when the program is over?
Yeah. They'll be back there packing and they'll come out here in this hallway probably. That's what I think.
Thank you so much.
You're
welcome. Wonderful performance.
Thank you.
We appreciate that.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. Excuse me, sir.
Danny.
How's this way testing?
I
guys just push back a little bit.
Without them and their efforts, this would not happen. There's an awful study of music and their pursuit of music, it's something they'll be able to do for the rest of their life, and it's something that is, it's hard to describe, but you, it's just hard to describe, but it's beautiful. So, thank you. Students, please give a round of applause to your parents.
Thank you. Encanto by Robert W. Smith, not to be confused with the latest release from Disney Plus, which is also pretty awesome, but it does have the same meaning, charmed and magical, and we really enjoyed putting this together for you. Speaking of magical, I just really want to say to you, the teachers, the parents, the friends, the family of these students, they have been magical. It has been my absolute pleasure to be here with them making music. It has been phenomenal. So thank you so much. I want to echo Dr. Ulrich's statement and just let you know how much it means to us to be able to make music with them, to have their support and all of the wonderful things that come with it. So thank you so much. We're going to go on to our next piece, A Hymn for Band. We hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Our next piece is a work called, entitled The Cave You Fear by Marco Markowski. And what is so fabulous about this piece is the meaning that kind of hides within it. When we first started learning, we talked about the hero's journey. And the title alludes to the cave that you fear holds the treasure you seek. And that kind of talks about the hero, if you watch a movie, all of the things that the hero has to go through to get what they want, right? Trials and tribulations, out of their comfort zone. And we were able to bring that into the things that we were doing and identify things that maybe we were holding us back or things that we weren't feeling brave about, especially in an honored band situation like this where you come in not knowing many people. So it was really fantastic to put this together, and it also allowed them to work on some extended techniques. If you listen carefully, you're going to hear some multiphonics from the saxophones, some glissandos into the trombones, some really interesting use of bouncy balls in the percussion section. So we hope you enjoy The Cave You Fear.
Thank you.
All right, so we're going to close words. Words are hard. We're going to close with one more piece for you. Not a traditional march. A march called March Diabolique, which we really enjoyed. So we kept it in the program by Brian Ballmages. So we hope you enjoy, and thank you so much for being here with us today. This is truly wonderful.
Thank you.
too.
How'd y'all get in so fast? Okay.
Third row.
Thank you.
Feel free to move to the edge. Explore your space.
Thank you. I
festival card, there's a UTM brochure, it should be a Department of Music brochure as well. So you can take all that stuff with you before you pass the program. So we'd love to have you join us for any of those things. Okay, without further delay, it's my pleasure to introduce our guest conductor for this event, Dr. Milt Allen. Milt, I've known Milt for quite a long time, and he is one of the most incredible human beings and musicians that I've had the pleasure of getting to know and working with. And I know the students have had a great time working with him. He's done wonderful work. So please welcome the Symphonic Band and their conductor, Dr. Milt Allen.
Good afternoon. We're going to be performing three selections for you. The first selection that we're going to do is the Symphony No. 4 by Andrew Boyson. For a lot of our students, it's the first symphony that they've played for band. How do you know when this thing ends? When both hands go down. So you're going to hear four movements, and there'll be some space in between those movements. So if you could hold your applause till the very last time when my hands finally go down. That way you don't have to nudge the person next now. No. When it's all done. Then the second piece we'll be doing is They Led My Lord Away, and then we'll be closing with just a closer walk with the ladies and gentlemen, the UT Honor Symphonic Band. Thank you. Could you hear okay? That was yesterday's morning breakfast. The first time I saw that piece was yesterday morning. So band directors, if you wonder how hard your kids can work, there's your answer. Normally, when I'm fortunate enough to do honor bands and things, you always have to do that obligatory, you know, these musicians were just so wonderful, and I told them, every time I do that, it gives me gray hair, and I'm actually 37, and you can see how my career's gone, right? This was a blast, an absolute blast. I mean, I asked them to step out of their comfort zones and be absolutely vulnerable, and they hook, line, sinker. Hook, line, sinker. It's just been a blast. So whatever you're feeding your kids here, or not feeding them, continue to do it. A big thing that we learn as we do honor bands, for those of us that are fortunate to stand in front, you get a real snapshot of what goes on in the classroom. And what an incredible snapshot this was of the teaching that's going on in your schools. I won't go and do a big diatribe about this, but I grew up in Kansas, and in Kansas, the one thing that you didn't want to have happen was not hear the train whistle. Because if the train whistle stopped, the town was dying. Stuff wasn't coming in. I think in schools, if you lose the arts, if you lose the music programs, the whistle's dying and the school's next. Do whatever you can, which I've already realized you've done a ton, to support your directors, to support the arts at your school. When you go back, send an email, or we used to write letters, and send it to your principal, send it to your Board of Education, and be sure to tell your directors thank you. Even though your directors are only at school about 4 hours a day, they all make six figures. They go home to palatial mansions, but they would still appreciate your support and thanks. One of the most challenging things that oftentimes we don't think about with honor bands is the size of the group. I don't know if you've noticed, this is a larger group. The majority of these students come from band programs that are 30 students or less. And in many cases, these students don't have the opportunity to play with tubas, let alone seven of them, or a full trombone section, or eight horns, or double reeds. To ask them to come together and go from 18, 20, 30 musicians in their band to a band of 100 with a full instrumentation is like taking a high school eight-man football team and telling them that tomorrow they're going to be playing in the NFL. It's not just reading the music. It's a whole different way of listening. I'm sorry to bring up the NFL. I am from Kansas. Just saying. But what? Took a minute. Chiefs Kingdom. But you got robbed. You got robbed. What they've accomplished is incredible. So kudos to them. It's been a blast. I'm just going to get out of your way.
Thank you.
Thank you. I'd like to reiterate what Dr. Ulrich said earlier, only with more hair. What UTM has going here, and in particular what Dr. Ulrich has done here, is amazing. This is a very unique environment to make music on, music in. Whether you're music education or whether you're just a student attending UTM, the student comes first. The person comes first. And ever since I've known John, that's how it is. I was here some years ago doing the honor band, and the changes in the program are just amazing. But what's really amazing is his students. The helpers that we've had with this band are incredible, and just watching his students and how they've put this festival on is just amazing. It's just incredible what UTM offers here, and in particular, what's going on with the music program here. Dr. Rolf could tell me about, well, you know, this kid just has an incredible heart, and boy, you know, he just incredible. And this kid is just a great person. And I said, really, how does that happen, John? How does a leader attract that kind of people, John? It's just an incredible environment. I'm so appreciative of the students and, of course, of Dr. Ulrich and the department here at UTM. So thanks so much. We're going to conclude our concert with just a little bit of a party. We're both happy and sad it's over, but we hope you enjoy a very calm rendition of just a closer walk with thee, and if you'd like to sing along, that's fine. And thank you for those of you who are watching in the nether regions. Really appreciate you being and watching via satellite. It sounds cooler. Sorry you couldn't be in here with us. They passed out money as people came in, but we're glad that you're here supporting your student.
Thank you. just so you know, when you go off by row, okay, use it or fold it in the cup and gel cover also in a tub. Cool? You guys are awesome. Rob.
You're going out this side? This side?
Yep. See, yep. Fourth row. So fourth row, you guys are good.
A little bit ago. Wait, is that Alyssa or Alyssa's mom?
I got your number. I'll text you.
I mean, didn't get just wheeled out in the hallway. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the second to last performance at the UTM Honor Band today. And this is a very special time because at this point, we get to introduce the winner of the Honor Band solo competition. And this is something that we started 8 years ago or so. And to encourage high level of playing amongst people, young musicians, as well as to encourage those folks who are interested in UTM to get maybe a little bit of an extra scholarship to come to UTM because of their exceptional musicianship. And this year, we had an incredible showing of musicians. I mean, all incredibly from my understanding, it was a difficult choice from all my colleagues and colleagues. But this year, our winner comes from one of our area schools, Henry County High School, from the direction of Mr. Kyle Graves, and it is, his name is Thomas Holcomb, and he's going to be playing some marimba for you. Please welcome our instrument solo competition winner, Thomas Holcomb. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, this is it.
The last one.
This is the UTM Honor Band Wind Ensemble. These are students from grades 9 through 12. And we are thrilled to perform our program for you today. Just a couple items of business. First of all, welcome. We're thrilled that you're here, and we're thrilled to have had these incredible musicians on campus this week. This is always a, this time of the year is a, it's a, it's a really busy thing. I conduct this band, but I also coordinate the festival, and so it's a lot of work, but I tell you what, when we get to this point, and we get to, I actually get to make music with these faces, it's so incredible. They have worked really hard on a really challenging program, and I think you're in for a treat. So just a couple of quick things. Exits in the doors that you came in, as well as right up here. Phones, please, no calls or texting, and turn your phone to silent or airplane mode if you would, please. We don't need enough, we would not like an electronic soul. Feel free to take photo or video, but just please turn off your flash because it's distracting to the musicians. If you would like to post to social media, please consider hashtag UTM Music on Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram. I hear we have TikTok now. I don't know. I don't know much about the TikToks. Would like to say thank you to our UTM administration, our department chair, Dr. Roberto Mancusi, our dean, Dr. Lynn Alexander, and our provost and vice chancellor for academic affairs, Dr. Phil Vicky Cavalier, for their support. We'd also like to thank my colleagues in the UTM Music Department for their assistance in producing the festival. I would especially like to thank all of my UTM Music students who are busy doing all the behind-the-scenes work. And without them, this would not happen. I am beyond blessed to have them as part of my life, and I am thankful every day that I get to work with them. So I would also like to thank the directors for preparing these fine young musicians to be here. Without them, this would not happen. If you are a director in the audience today, would you please stand and let us recognize you? Okay, well, that's the end of that. The next work on the program is Gustav Holst's Second Suite in F. This piece has four movements. Please hold your applause in between. It is based on folk music from England, and it is one of the biggest standards that we have in the wind band repertoire. This is something that really great high school programs would play, as well as college programs as well. It's something that all of my students, I try to get them to play this at least once every 4 years. We hope you enjoy Gustav Holst's Suite in F, Second Suite in F. Just quickly, the movements are the march, then the second movement is Song Without Words, which does have words. It's very sad. But ends, it's a happy ending. I'll spare you the explanation. The third movement is called The Blacksmith, and I think that will be self-explanatory. And the last movement is Fantasia on the Dargasan, which is the theme of the Irish washerwoman. You'll hear it first in saxophone and then passed around the ensemble. We hope you enjoy Second Suite now.
Thank you. Thank you.
The next piece in the program is by a younger American composer who was actually never in band when he was a kid, and his name is John Mackey. He has become a very, very popular voice in composition. He is, it's fresh, it's crunchy, it's beautiful. This piece is lyrical and gorgeous, and it sounds like for those band aficionados in the crowd, if you know Percy Grainger's settings of folk songs like Irish Jew from County Derry, or Eubanks and Grays, or Colonial Song especially, it has that kind of a flavor, but with Maggie's harmonic language, this is just, if you're not crying at the end of the cry right now, so we haven't climbed up yet. So we hope you enjoy John Mackey's Sheltering Sky.
Thank you.
All right, the last piece on the program is by Brian Balmages, and it is entitled Arabian Dances, and I think that kind of speaks for itself. It's based on two Arabian folk songs and then one original melody. And this has been just a blast to work on with these five musicians. It has an incredible feature for our percussionists in the middle, playing on some authentic Middle Eastern instruments. We hope you enjoy Arabian Dances, and please come back to campus and bring these five musicians with you. This has been a wonderful, wonderful few days. Arabian Dances.
Thank you.
ensemble.